No one knows skiing quite like Ron LeMaster. That's what other skiers like Nicholas Heron will tell you.
He was someone that people always look to and turn to help provide information and educate instructors across the country.
Now the CEO of the Professional Ski Instructors of America and American Association of Snowboard Instructors, Heron worked with LeMaster many times over the years. He says LeMaster didn't just have skills on the skis.
Well, I think everyone's going to remember Ron from seeing him on the side of the hill with his camera.
LeMaster was a talented photographer of the sport, using his photos of other skiers to help educate and write about the mechanics of skiing.
What he did through his imagery, he allowed people to understand what it meant and how to be a better skier and a high-level skier.
And people took notice.
He's someone, they are the first courses that are sold out. Whenever Ron is giving a presentation or engaging with snow sports instructors, that's a room that people want to be in because his energy and love of the sport and his detail and understanding of alpine skiing, he was one of the best in the industry.
A legacy left not only on the sport, but on helping others.
All of us as educators have looked to Ron to better understand the science of skiing. And I know I used his resources, his manuals, and you know, you have to have mentors. And I know Ron was a mentor to many in this industry to better understand how they can be a better instructor out on the hill.
And LeMaster was also a husband, a father, and a friend. Kim, as you can imagine, social media already filling with so many different tributes. I actually caught up with one of Ron's friends, who's also a ski instructor. She was telling me just how compassionate of a person that he was and how he really just encouraged other skiers to get better.
If there was anyone who knew about skiing and all the technicalities, it was Ron LeMaster of Boulder. The 72-year-old snow sports educator died Tuesday on the Windmill Run at Eldora Mountain. Investigators say he collided with a snowboarder on a day that was not particularly busy. Today we spoke with his longtime friend, Ron Kipp, who told us LeMaster in the ski community was a pillar, a coach's coach.
I think for me personally, it was his curiosity about every aspect of skiing, that inquisitiveness nature that he had was just so addictive that it made you want to get better.
LeMaster taught countless classes, offering video analysis of skiing techniques for both coaches and skiers. He authored several books like Ultimate Skiing and The Skier's Edge.
His depth of knowledge was people will just never know how deep he was. He was the ultimate. If you had a new idea, he'd go, yeah, that was talked about by Smith in 1939. You know, he would know what has happened out there.
LeMaster was the master of the slopes, now gone, still loved, and very missed.
I mean, we left this place in such a frantic state. Hello. It's been a couple of weeks, and a lot has happened. So, you know, the last vlog, I basically was like, hey, Alex is getting ready to go down to the mountain, or go down to Boulder, and, that Ron, Alex's dad. God damn, this sucks. On November 30th, which is when we left the condo, I was tattooing at the shop, and I got a phone call from Alex's mom. I got a couple of phone calls and I missed them. And then I got a text from Alex saying that there was an emergency. The unthinkable, the biggest fear that probably any of us have,
and just downright devastating is the news that Ron, Alex's dad, was killed while he was skiing. And Ron LeMaster is an expert skier. I mean, Ron LeMaster changed skiing in a whole. Ron, I've showed you books. We have photos all over the condo. Ron's a pro. Like, he is who teaches the people who teach you how to ski. I'm not even a skier, and I know the gravity and the weight that this man carried around in credentials. Incredible. Like, there's enough to fill a museum in just this condo of his accomplishments. And those are just his ski accomplishments. All kinds of other accomplishments in engineering. He worked for IBM. He did amazing things, but bro, like, what the fuck, you know? Like, holy fucking shit, you know? Like, that basically, life has been flipped upside down. We don't have any fucking clue what we're doing. Alex's mom is not in, like, you know, 100% health. That's why we moved here, was to help be around so we could take care of Alex's mom. Alex is obviously crushed. Alex's mom is obviously crushed. Like, I'm crushed. It's just so fucking sad and unfair, and it's just been devastating. The last couple of weeks have just been so crazy and emotional. Man, it just, the hits just keep coming. He passed on the 30th. We had a viewing the following Tuesday, and then literally as soon as we got home from the viewing, Alex's mom was rushed to the ER and had to stay in the hospital for 5 days. Thankfully, she's doing so much better now. Her mom is home, and like, I'm able to leave. I was able to come to the condo. I had to finish a tattoo yesterday, and I wanted to go ride this morning because we're all scared shitless. We've all had the fear of death put into our ski experience, and it's tragic as fuck, and we're not anywhere close to getting over it. And part of getting over that is to ski. And I just say ski because I can't stand boarding. I just say ski. But the only thing Ron would want us to do is to keep skiing, not be afraid of the mountain. Fucking people, man. Like, some dude killed my girl's dad, you know? Some dude who was going too fucking fast down a mountain with no snow ran into a man who is a technical fucking professional, destroyed him, dude. Like, broke his neck, his back, his ribs, lacerated his spleen, bruised his heart. Like, he crushed him. Fucking people, dude. Like, if you're gonna ski or snowboard or do anything, dude, take a lesson. Learn how to stop. Learn how to control yourself. It's not fun and games, dude. Like, this dude's probably fucked. Mentally, he's certainly fucked. There's repercussions to your actions, and the wake of that person's actions is huge. Gargantuan, you know, it's changed lives forever. Like, it's fucking insane. It's been insane. It's been the most insane 2 weeks of my entire life. So, and all I want to do is be there for Alex. Like, I don't care about anything else right now. I'm there for Alex and her mom. My focus has been just those two for the last couple of weeks, and it will continue to be that for the foreseeable future until we get a groove going on what our new life looks like. As you know, we just moved into the condo because Alex's dad and mom allowed us to move here so we could enjoy the ski season. I could help with Peter's shop, and we could be close by. Well, we didn't even have to have a conversation about it. Me and Alex both, like, we're moving to Boulder. So we're now moving to Boulder. I don't know what my tattoo schedule is going to be. I don't even know what I'm going to do. I'm giving up the office here that we just rented. I'm going to go get that emptied out today. That's why I'm up here. Take it all down to Boulder and start over fresh. I mean, I don't really know what we're going to do. You know, the timing is just all these things. You know, if we were still in Vegas trying to figure this out, this would be a fucking nightmare. I mean, it's already a nightmare, but it'd have levels of nightmare going on. So, or more levels. An abrupt record stop. Like, it's just, it's devastating. I will not be able to express this probably ever. This is going to be something that's going to be in our lives forever. There's never going to be a time where, I mean, three technically with Alex, the most involved in me really being able to ride a mountain and be around these areas are gone. You know, Peter, my friend, person that got me out here. And then once I started dating Alex, her family has been so gracious to me and allowed me to come up here and ride. And those are really the two anchors in, like, me ever coming here and ever getting to experience this type of life. And they are gone. Like, it is just fucking heartbreaking. And it's a lot to work through, but that's just what it is. Like, I have to take the time to just work through it, and that's what we've been doing, and we find a lot of peace in certain things. You know, he died on the mountain. He died doing what he loved. He never fucking saw it coming. There's many things that we can sit here and be thankful for because we have to. Because we have to find ways to cope with such a huge loss, and we have to look at the bright side of things, or else the world is just dark. I went snowboarding this morning just to get it over with. It was super windy and cold, not the best conditions at all, but I went anyway and I had a little bit of fun and I got it done. No longer fearful of just getting railed by somebody, but it could happen, you know, like it's fucking crazy. Same as an automobile. Someone just fucking sideswipes you and it's game over. People don't give a fuck about other people. We all say we give a fuck, but when it comes down to it, in people's actions, most people don't give a fuck. Let's start with returning our shopping carts and letting people merge on the highway. Then maybe we could not kill other people by accidentally being reckless. I don't know if that's an accident or a choice, but so we're obviously all a little upset. It's not easy getting over this one, and I don't think there is no getting over it. It's just processing it to the point where we can live with it, because we don't, again, we don't have a choice. Straight up, day by day. It's Christmas morning. Dirty Ern is in town. Alex isn't here. Alex is at home with her mom. They both gave me permission to come snowboard for a couple of days. We always went skiing with Ron on Christmas, so I felt it to be important and I wanted to be here. I'm going to shred today and tomorrow probably, and maybe even the next day. But beautiful, beautiful snow. It's gonna be a good day. We're gonna see Dirty Ern, so you know, it's been a minute.
Easy. I'm already doing 360 ollie kickflips. You know.
Why is there a mouth hole?
It's the air hole. These are the new. These are the Republican versions. Okay. Jake.
Eddie.
What up? Good to see you.
Good to see you, man.
What do you mean you're ready?
I can't hear anything.
Okay.
I'm ready.
All right.